let us, amen, give the Lord another hand of praise. I want to thank you for being here today and showing up for God. I know God is pleased that you showed up and you were here. As a result of you pleasing God, you're considered to be blessed. Blessed beyond measure. I would like for you to take your Bibles and go to the book of Romans, the 8th chapter, the 26th verse. Give honor to God, give an honor to God who's ahead of my life, and to First Lady in her absence, you know, keep her in prayer, and to all the leadership, amen, and to auxiliary department heads, all the elders, the ministers, the missionaries, evangelists, deacon, district missionaries, and to all of those that are here. And, you know, the most important person other than us is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. So we are in the presence of royalty. Amen. They are here and we are here. Wow. We're in a divine state. And sometimes we must recognize that when we're in church. In fact, our divine state should not stop in the sanctuary, but it should leave here with that same type of spirit, because the Bible says every day is holy unto the Lord. So you shouldn't get into that divine state on Sunday morning. And on Wednesday, I heard somebody say, wow. And you know what I'm saying? That you can't jump out of that divine state and jump back in it. It's a place that you have to be all the time. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Jesus said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. I'll be with you always. And that word always means there's not a time where I won't be with you for those that are in that divine state. Now, I'll get to reading in a moment. Are you with me now? And so you ought to sometimes be happy because you're not as alone as you think you are. And those things that you think you're going through by yourself, go on, sit down. Go on, sit down. And just have a seat. Those things that you think that you're going through by yourself, you're not going through by yourself. Christ is going through with you, so you're not by yourself. Yes. Amen. You are in that divine state, yes, in the presence of the Lord. And you will yourself to be there. It's a will of the Father that you be there, but he gives you a choice to will to be there. In other words, he said, if you want to be saved, confess with your mouth. Amen. That God has raised Christ Jesus from the dead, the anointed one, according to the scripture, and you shall be saved. Now, if you want to be saved, because he said, I'm going to put the word with you, because he said the word is near you or nigh you. You confess it, amen, but you got the will to do that. So you are in the divine. So some of you that are in the divine state all the time, you ought to give the Lord a hand praise. When I think of the goodness of God. You better leave that alone. He did what done wrong. What cries out? What does it cry out? I think. But what? Oh, yeah. You in that divine state today. You in the presence of God. You're sitting in heavenly places. I'll get to the scripture. You'll be all right. Amen. But you're sitting in heavenly places. And so, you may be going through a little something, but guess what? Christ is there with you. You're not by yourself in what you are dealing with and what you are going through. You have the second person in the Trinity with you, and that's Christ. And if Christ is with you, guess what? God the Father and God the Son, God the Holy Ghost is there too, because the Bible said these three are one. So you are enjoying the presence of God with the Trinity in mind. Oh, yeah. You're looking good today. Ella Miller said something that got me all excited. Ella Miller, he said, I see you in the future. Oh, Lord have mercy. Oh, Lord have mercy. You looking good. Look at Mr. Harrison. That man's smiling. He got a big smile on his face. The future looks good. Are you with me now? Deacon Mackey, you looking good. And Simmons, you looking really good today. You're smiling. I see the smile on your face. You must be in the presence of the Lord. I see you in the presence. You look like you're going to look like in the future because you got a smile on your face. When I think of the goodness of Jesus, thank you. minutes left, so please be seated. Yeah, I'm telling you. Sometimes I need a praise on my own. I don't need anybody to talk me into praise. I just need a praise on my own. And sometimes it may seem that I'm out of order, you know what I'm saying? But I walk in here sometime and need to get a praise on my own. Have you ever walked in the church wanting to get a praise on your own? Wanted to release yourself. And then somebody said, well, you acting out of character. You may, oh, yeah, yes, I am, because I'm in the church. And it's my opportunity to give God the glory, because sometimes you can't do it like you want to do it on your job. But when you come into the sanctuary, the Bible said, when the saints get together, they're awesome in the presence of God. And sometimes you have to get a praise on your own. And that person sitting beside you said, I don't want to hear the word. And he said, well, excuse me while I get my praise on my own. You're going to get the word, but excuse me while I take this opportunity to give God glory, because I'm in the presence of God and I recognize where I am right now. And God's been too good for me. You know what I'm saying? He's been too good for me, and so I just want to act it out. Bible said, the Logos, Romans 8 and 26. Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groaning and which cannot be uttered. And he that searches the heart knoweth what is in the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercessions for the saints according to the will of God. Now that's key there, not to your will, but okay. And we know that all things work together for the good to them that love God, to them who are what? Who are what? Some of you say call, but it said duh. So you probably according to his purpose. So the call are the people that it's going to work out for. And so we get excited, even the person that's not really serving God. Here's that scripture say, it's going to work out for my good, but I don't want you to be deceived if you're not of the goal. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It cannot work out for your good. And if it done that, if it happens to do that, that means that God has shown his mercy and his grace. But for the goal, it's going to work out. As I was studying this thing, the Lord spoke to me and he said, tomorrow, today is the birthplace of tomorrow. Right. Next week is the birthplace of another week. Without one week, there cannot be another. Without today, there can't be tomorrow. Yeah. 1 year is the birthplace of another year, and a decade is the birthplace of a decade. And so forth and so on. And Elder Miller, I like what he said. I see you in your future. But all of these timelines are the descendant of today. The years to come, the weeks to come, the millennia to come are a descendant of today. Guess this. They are a descendant of today. That means that today actually controls your tomorrow, your week, your decade, and your months and your millennia. All right. Because what you do today determines your tomorrow. Yeah. And the decisions that you make determines what happens to you on tomorrow. Tomorrow may try to go another way, but how you handle tomorrow determines on how you are today. How you are today determines about how you deal with tomorrow. What is done today is magnified in tomorrow. Controlling tomorrow changes our return. It makes a change in our return or our dividends. It causes us to receive, to go into the negative or to the positive, or the positive of tomorrow. Meaning that it has nothing to do with what you have and what you don't have. It has to do with your spiritual attitude. Matthew, Jesus spoke in the 6th chapter, 33rd verse and 34th verse. He said, don't worry about tomorrow. You work on today. Today got it. Tomorrow has its own problem. But if you get yourself together today, you'll be able to handle tomorrow. Tomorrow can take care of itself all by itself. Don't bring what you got today into tomorrow. Just handle it today. If you have emotional difficulties, handle it today. Because when you get into tomorrow, you won't be able to, there's no need to take what you're dealing with today into tomorrow. But if your attitude is right today, whatever comes tomorrow, you'll be able to handle that with that right attitude. Because tomorrow is the birthplace, today is the birthplace of tomorrow. Are you with me? How I deal with things now will determine the outcome of tomorrow. I tell people, you have two decisions. Either worry or not worry. You say, Pastor, it's too easy. You're just saying, that's too hard. Well, if Jesus said, cast all of my cares upon, all your cares upon me because I care for you, that means that you have a decision to do it today so you won't have it tomorrow. Today actually changes how you interface with somebody else tomorrow. Y'all with me? What I think of you today will determine how I treat you tomorrow. If I have an attitude on with you today, whether it's positive or negative, it will determine my reaction to you tomorrow. Let me fix this. I don't have any problem with y'all out there. But if I make a decision today to cast my cares upon the Lord, whether you attack me tomorrow or not, I'm still going to treat you the same way that I treat you today. I'll tell you what it has to do with the scripture in a minute. The Bible said, Proverbs 3, 23 and 7. Get this. So as a man thinketh, so is he. If you think that you are this way today, guess what you're going to wake up in the morning and think that you are. But if you think that you are a king's kid, guess what? When you wake up in the morning, you're going to be a king's kid. If you think that you are blessed when you get up in the morning, you may not have everything that you want to have. But the Bible said, He provides everything according to your need. You'll have exactly what you need. And so you can get up in the morning and praise God. Amen. Because you're a king's kid. And when you think you're a sore loser, guess what? When you get up in the morning, you're going to be a sore loser. Because you have determined that today that you're going to be a sore loser tomorrow. You're actually bringing that and you're birthing that into existence. If you think it, so you become. That's what Proverbs 23 and 7 says. Well, Pastor, you don't know what I'm dealing with. Nothing. For the Bible said the earth is the Lord and what? And the fullness thereof, everything that you dealing with, which is nothing. I'm not being insensitive to what you're dealing with. But I'm saying when you put it with God, when you put it, when you measure it, when you compare it with God, you're dealing with nothing. And so how, amen, you recognize God today is how you're going to recognize Him tomorrow. Amen. If you want to be in God's divine presence, amen, tomorrow you get it with His divine presence today so you can wake up in the morning. If God decides for you to wake up, guess what? You wake up in the morning in God's presence, in His divine presence. Go to, amen, Romans 8 and 18. It says, "For I reckon that the suffering of this present time are not worthy to be what compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us." You don't know what on the inside of you, but what's on the inside of you looks a lot better than what you see right now. The glory that's on the inside of you is stupendous, amen, when it compared with the suffering that you're going through right now. You're looking good. I'm telling you, you're looking good. You just are not looking good because you have nice shoes on, Deacon Mackey. You're cold continent. There's something about you. You're shining. You're glowing. I mean, you probably put that suit in the cleaner. So what? But it's not about the suit today. It's about what the person that's wearing the suit. It's about the spiritual being that's, amen, being covered by the suit. Because there's some, are you with me now? You're looking good today. And you're in the divine presence of God because you understand that your suffering has nothing to do, amen, with what you, with the glory that's on the inside of you. I mean, you being glorified even in your suffering. And when you compare your suffering with God, it's nothing. Because you're always in the divine presence of God. Proverbs said, don't be boasting about tomorrow because you don't know what a day may bring. But how you control tomorrow is you deal with it today. Don't leave the praise in the sanctuary. Take it out of the church. Praise him in the car. But keep your hands on the steering wheel. Sing a song of praise. You know, you can get excited, but you know what I'm saying? Watch the stop sign and watch the stop light. Don't get so excited. You know what I'm saying? But take it in your car and begin to praise God. Take it in your home. And every now and then you need to shout your home out. Are you with me now? You need to shout your home out. The same shout you bring in the sanctuary, sometimes you need to shout your home out. Some of us home need a good shouting, a good praising God. For the writer says that for me and my house, we're going to serve God. Sometimes you need to take the same praise that you have in the sanctuary into your home. And you need to shout. Somehow, need to know what a shout feel like. I'm about to go. Decisions that are made today determine the journey of life that you will be taking tomorrow on. So if you don't know the Lord as your personal Savior, man, you know him today, and your journey begins with Christ today. Yeah. Well, that sounds good. That sounds good. I still live here on earth, but I will be in God's divine presence. I won't be the same people that people say that I was. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I was, because I'm gonna turn my life. They used to call me a hard-headed kid. You know, that's okay. I've been hard-headed before. I ain't been saved all my life. I've been hard-headed before. But when I go home, they say, "You the whole hard-headed kid that they used to know." No. I'm not the hard-headed kid. But I understand why they're calling me that, because Jesus wasn't even received in his own city. They called him the carpenter's son. They couldn't see that he was the Savior. And so people are going to remember you as that old hard-headed, trifling, no good nothing, stuttering kid. And you're not that anymore. I mean, sin is not on the inside of you anymore. I mean, you dead to sin because you have Christ in your life. Are you with me now? So what you do today will determine your journey and destiny tomorrow. If you have financial problems, oh, praise the name. My Father is rich in houses and land. I'm going through a little difficulties, but I'm going to call on the name of the Lord. He may want to sell some of those cattle. Okay. You know what I'm saying? He may want to sell some of those cows, but some people want the beef, and I'm just going to get the residue. I'd like to have everything. God, just send me the residue. Just send me the interest on the payment of the cow. Just send me the interest. If you got God's interest, you have enough. You know what I'm saying? Oh, I got. pseudo good means that whatever happens here on earth, you're satisfied with. And you're going to die, but you won't die with it because somebody else is going to get your property. Pseudo good is temporary satisfaction. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And you've been to some place where you pseudo good. You know what I'm saying? Leave it alone, Pastor. This holiness is coming out of me. You know what I'm saying? In those clubs, that's pseudo good. For that moment, you know, you're praying. You're not praising God, but you know what I'm saying. You're dancing. You're not dancing like David danced, but you're having this pseudo good. It's an excitement for a moment, and pseudo good is temporal. For that moment, you are feeling good. But Jesus told, amen, told a parable of the man said, and of the man in Luke, I think the 12th chapter. He said, you know what? I got all of this food. I'm going to put it in the barn, and I'm going to have pseudo good. I'm going to have temporary pleasure. But he didn't get it because God said, this night I require your soul. But there's something called eternal good. And eternal good, amen, comes from Philippians. It means that it can start here and now today, and it will go to you to eternity. What you have in God today, you will take with you to eternity. I'm not talking about material things. I'm talking about spiritual things. That joy, and that joy of today, and that joy of tomorrow. I'm talking about those things that make you feel good. That praise that you have, amen. You're going to take it with you today into heaven. That's eternal good. So I get an opportunity to enjoy God here. Enjoy my little shoes. By Stacey Adams here. But the Bible, guess this. Pull my coat down 10 minutes. Make sure you pull it. I'm on the road today. I get to enjoy what God blesses me with today. Because he did tell me, and if I ask anything in his name, he's going to do it for me. He did tell me that I'm going to be blessed in the city and blessed in the field. I'm going to be blessed going out. I'm going to be blessed coming in with Romans 28. So I get to enjoy the blessings of God today. And I get, and in my spirit, the spirit man takes it into eternity because the praise that I have today, I take the praise in heaven. And these Stacey Adams are not going to mean anything anymore because I'm going to have to take my shoes off because the Stacey Adams can't touch the street of gold. I'm going to be walking on gold. You know that thing on gold. That stuff on your finger? That stuff on your finger, I'm going to be walking on. Oh, so you think you're sharp today? You sharp today, but that stuff you got on ain't but filter rag. It's going to rotten. It's going to mold. It's going to deteriorate. Guess what? And you're going to walk on the street of gold. Oh. Ooh. Come give me a high five, because maybe that might come to me for that. Give me a high five, man. Yeah. Okay, I'm glad. Who you are. Who you are and whose you are. Who you are and whose you are. Man does not compare to what the devil is trying to throw my way because I know who I am, whose I am, and you know what I'm saying, who I am, and I know whose I am. Now let me tell you, Philippians 4:11 says, Paul said, this is eternal good. He said, not that I speak from want, but I've learned to be content. He was talking spiritual things. That's eternal good. If you can be content today, man, even if you're eating pork and beans tomorrow, it'll be all right. Then it got sophisticated. Now they don't call them pork and beans all the time. They call them baby beans. But I don't want to disappoint you. They're pork and beans. Tell them, yeah! I don't want to, I want to tell you, show you how great you are. John 15 and 16, Jesus was talking to his disciples. I'm going to show you how great you are. Amen. Because greatness is not in the ability for you to choose. Greatness is an ability for someone else to choose you. So Jesus told his disciples, don't get the big head. In John 15 and 16, you didn't choose me. I chose you. And so, and are you with me? I chose you, because and if I chose you, there's some greatness is on the inside of you. Stop worrying about what people think about you. If God chose you, maybe there's something that's on the inside of you that God wants to bring out. He chose you now. He chose you. And so you ought to get excited about being chosen by God. And the 29th verse in the Romans 8 and 29 said, he predestined you. He foreknew you. He knew you before you came in church today. He knew you before you were born. And he predestined. He had pre-knowledge that you were getting ready to come into this world. And he chose you to be here this day and this moment to give him glory and to praise him. You ought to give God thank you, because you don't have the ability to choose God. He chooses you, because there's something on the inside of you that God said he likes. Oh, I like that. I like that.
Yeah.
game to it. I better stop with the pool detail. It got grown up there. Why you head over to the building?